Hello everybody, Jakob here, and welcome back to another episode of Redstone Mini. Today we are going to be looking at the Box of Death. This is another trap made by Redstone, and by far, this is one of my favorites. I highly recommend playing around with this one, and the reason I love this one so much is because you have so many options. You can add so many little parts and detail to add to this that make it better and funner any way you want to use it. So, real quick, I'll show you what it does, and then we can actually go look at it in a deeper way. So, of course, it kills someone, but that's optional, and I'll talk about that later. So, this is what it looks like. It's very compact. It's really only four across and four, I don't know. Anyway, it's just 4x4. It's not very big at all. You could put it almost anywhere, and what happens is when you step on this pressure plate, there's a block right there that will push you up into that cobweb and lava will come out. So you are stuck and you will die. These signs are here to keep the lava from flowing out. And obviously, cobweb to get you stuck. So real quick, I'll demonstrate it. And then we'll just learn a little bit more about it. So let's just say you're a guy. You want to raid a base and you see a random entrance. So, hey, there's probably diamonds in there. Let's run. So guy's running and bam, you got pushed up in the cobwebs. What? And then lava. And obviously, by the time you get down and get out, you'll be long and dead. You know what's the great thing about this is that this can be used over and over and over again. So it's not just a one-time use. So all you have to do is go back to the pressure plate you stepped on, press on it again, and bam, it's gone, just like that. And once again, just wait for your next victim to fall in. So yeah, as you guys, it's a pretty simple redstone. Really, what there is over here is you got this pressure plate hitting this repeater, which will turn this one off, and then on, giving power to that dispenser when you get on this. Also, below this is a piece of redstone that is hooked up to a piston right there to push you. This repeater right here is set at 4 ticks, and this repeater is at no ticks. Alright, so we have three more things to do. Real quick, I will show you all the optional things you can do with this machine, then we will build one, and then we will look at the cons and the pros for this design. So, some of the optional things are the signs at these two corners. So, as you can see on this other design, there are signs so lava doesn't spill everywhere, but really, those are completely optional. Even if you don't have the signs there, it will not really go everywhere. So, this one has lava in it, and if we click on it real quick, as you can see, the lava comes out, and it'll pour all the way here. It'll come to this pressure plate and then stop because it can't go any further, and on this side, it'll spill a little bit out the back. So really, signs are actually optional. Of course, turned off, you just click on it again. You might get a little bit messy on this other side, but if all you have is stone on this other side, then it's really not a big deal. Next thing that is optional is the web on top. So the web up here is totally optional, except this adds a much higher rate of death if you actually want to kill someone. So if we just go through it without the web, as you can see, we're up here and then the lava comes. But you can also walk out of it and maybe live. Maybe. I mean, still the lava's on you and then you're still burnt. But again, option. And then the last option is lava is an option. If you actually don't want to kill your friend, just take the lava bucket out. This entire redstone thing doesn't even have to be here. It can be a 3x4. It doesn't even matter. Let me just get a cobweb out. Just put a cobweb up here. With no lava, your friend will just get stuck in here. It'll make them mad, but then they can walk away without getting hurt or losing. So guys, real quick, let's just look at the pros and cons, and then we will build this, and this episode of Redstone Mini will be over. So the pros are very compact. Obviously, with all the perks also, you can make this very small, and it still can be put almost anywhere, which is another one of the perks. Next is it's not expensive. As we can see, this is all the materials needed. 3 redstone pieces, maybe a lava bucket, maybe a cobweb, maybe signs, dispenser, 2 repeaters, redstone torch, building blocks, and 1 pressure plate. And lastly, it's funny. Even if they die or if they don't die, either way, it's funny though. Cons, destroys all the items the player has. And that's not always true. If you use lava, the player's items will get destroyed, but you don't have to. And can be very easily noticed. This one cannot be noticed as easily because it doesn't have signs. You don't have to put cobwebs or dispenser there. It really, the only thing that gives it away is the pressure plate, and people can overlook that very easily. This one, on the other hand, can be noticed very, very easy. I mean, signs, dispenser, cobweb, pressure plate, all of them combined, it's very, very easy to kind of spot it. But next, let's actually build one. So again, like I went through, cobwebs are optional, signs are optional, the lava is optional, so is the dispenser then, because the lava goes in the dispenser. Things that are not optional is you do need 3 pieces of redstone, building blocks, pressure plate, 1 repeater if you're not using lava, but 2 if you are, 1 sticky piston, and a redstone torch. So, real quick, let's just go over here and build it real quick. So, what you need is to lay out 4 ground spots that you want it to go in. So, let's just pick these 4 spots. Next, you want to put the pressure plate on the first one and go under it and put a piece of redstone right there. Next, take a repeater, put it down, set it to 4 ticks, and then put a sticky piston right over there and a block on top of it, then another block right there. Next, go right beside it, put a piston right there, then put a block with a torch on it. Let me get the torch out. Put the torch right there, put a block on top of it, and then put a block right next to the torch, and then one up higher. So then take your redstone, put it right there, and right there. Then actually build your wall just like this. Put the dispenser right there, and then just build the rest of your wall like that. And like that. Build up your wall at least 3 high, I think, because you need a little room for the cobwebs. Then leave 1 room above the pressure plate for the cobweb. Darn it. Okay, there we go. Take the cobweb out. And there you go, it's done. And if you want to add the signs over there, it's all good. And bam, it's done. The entire machine is done. I built it, I think, in less than a minute, which is very surprisingly. So now if we go in it, you guys can see that it works, but I don't think I put the lava in the dispenser real quick. That's practically the last step. And now we can go through it and try it. Bam, done, lava, oh no. And then I come back and put it off. So guys, that is how easy you can build it, and I'm very happy with this design. So guys, thank you for watching. Make sure to leave a like and a comment as it supports my channel, and I'll see you guys later. God bless, and goodbye.